In this video, we are going to talk about data types. You can see a lot of data here on the chart. Data is used whenever something is automated in an expert advisor, and it's important to choose the right kind of data type to get the proper output. So let's find out how to do that. We start by clicking on the little icon here, or you can press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template. Let's click on Continue. I will call this version SimpleDataTypes. Click on Continue, Continue and Finish. And now we can delete everything above the OnTick function and the two command lines here. Let's start with the most obvious data type. This is for text values. We will use a so-called string variable. In our case, the words "the current value is" are assigned to our variable called text. And probably you have already seen the data type variable in one of the previous videos. This one is used to output time. It's called myTime. And I'm using a function here that is called timeLocal. It says that it will return the time of a computer where the client terminal is running. So let's use the command function to output our text, followed by the value. And when you're done, you can click on the compile button or press F7. We don't have any errors here. So now we click here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. In the previous videos, we have learned how to use the strategy tester, so let's click on View, Strategy Tester, pick the new file for the data types, enable the visual mode here, and start a test. Now we get the output, the current value is, followed by a strange number. We would have expected the time here, but it's not in a format that we can read. This is also possible. We are going to talk about that later in a video about typecasting. But let's continue with data types. We use the data type double whenever we are dealing with floating type values. For example, for the balance, we need to have a few digits behind the dot. We just add the 12 cents in our source code. Let's see how the new balance value will look on the chart. Restart the test, and this time our output is the current value is 100,000.12. But we don't always need floating type values. For example, the account number is a whole number. We get it by using account info integer for the account login. Let's recompile, start a new test, and here we have our account number. It's 165,2880. So whenever you deal with whole numbers, you can use the data type int. And when you want to know if something is true or false, we would use the bool type. Bool type is intended to store logical values of true or false, and it will create an output of 1 or 0. So let's put this one into the command line. Recompile. Restart the test. The current value is 1. That stands for true. Let's change that to false. And now we get the current value is 0. That stands for false. There are a few more data types available. Just press F1 and search for data types. And you should find some more. It's always a good idea to write short programs to find out what's going on. And in this little video, you learned how to create outputs for different data types. And you have done it yourself with a few lines of MQL4 code.